Okay, amended budget adoption, is this you, Mark?
Yes, in your packets you have budgets that have been amended since the adoption at our June meeting, the June 26th meeting we adopted. Budgets for this fiscal year 13-14. There's basically four budgets. The capital budget, the commission budget, the train operations budget, and the HPA budget that were previously adopted. Since their adoption, we have revised them to include class codes and account numbers specific to expenditure line items, which weren't included in the original adoption. And then also, with our new financial system, is we have worked to classify expenses. There were some budgets that didn't have ample line items to track desirable expenses. So we have added some line items in some of the budgets to be able to track expenditures. And those are denoted in these budgets as well. So the top of the budget, you'll see a revision date on there. The first one in your packet is the capital budget. Really, there has not been any significant changes in this budget other than the class codes, some language within the expenditure line items, and the account numbers. The numbers have not changed in the capital budget.
At all?
I do not believe at all. Okay. On the commission budget, similarly.
Mr. Chairman, should we act on these individually?
Sure, I think so.
I move we accept the executive director's change in the capital projects budget.
Second.
All in favor, say aye.
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 Opposed?
Yeah, really didn't
like it. One thing I'd like to just expand upon too, at my first meeting as an observer, not as executive director, I know Leo had presented some amended budgets for you guys to consider, and the question came up whether there was a need to send them to the states as amended budgets, and the answer is no. The budgets are primarily for our use, and they will be critical, I believe, when the auditors come in and look at expenditures as well. And I think the new system, as we intend to set it up, will be able to do budget to actual comparisons for you. So just point of clarification, these budgets are for our own financial purposes. Okay. Moving on is the commission budget. Again, there are only minor changes in account numbers, class codes, and some language within the expenses. And none of the numbers have changed as well in the commission budget. Any questions?
I don't think there needs to be a motion on that, correct?
Well, if we're modifying them.
If we're modifying them?
Yeah.
Okay.
Again, with the acknowledgement that there's no change on numbers, I'd move that we accept the change of format.
Second.
Discussion?
One point of clarification. When we added a line item, we may have deducted funds from a like line item to fund that line item. So the numbers did change, but the overall totals are not changing.
The total revenues and the total either bottom line has not changed.
Correct.
Okay.
So I just want to clarify that.
Good.
Commissioner Lowe?
Just by way of warning all of us, at a recent retreat, I was told by History Colorado, namely Joseph Bell, that because the organization is having difficulty paying for its new facility, basically they're cash short. The idea has been expressed that those of us who live off of the work that they do, particularly with the legislature and in administering the monies that we get, should be remunerated in some form of a fee. So this is nothing more than an idea, which I loudly protested, but we'll see where it goes.
Okay, any other questions, comments? Okay, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried. Next?
The next budget is the HPA budget. Similarly, again, new class codes, new account numbers for specific line items. And I don't believe this budget has changed at all, with exception of those two areas.
Move for approval.
Second.
Discussion? None? Okay, all in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? Motion carried.
The last budget is the train operations budget. Starts off with the first page as a budget summary. You'll notice in the ridership section at the top, there's a highlighted area. This budget, John and staff prepared, and John was new to the job and working on trying to establish a very lean budget. And as we worked through funding some specific line items in some of his departmental budgets, it was hard to fund. So John and I discussed, based on the increased ridership numbers, increasing this portion as part of this budget revision, which consequently increases the revenue as well. And that way we could fund some of the items within the budget, within various departments. And this budget is broken down into the administration budget, the operations budget, which has train operating, ticket and reservations, onboard services, retail, food and beverage. It also has the marketing department, special event department, mechanical, and a new department, which we didn't have previously and couldn't fund in any of these other departments, and that's a facilities department. That's the one that we were really needing to find some funds to fund. So this budget has incurred quite a few changes. It has the changes similar as the other budgets with class codes and account numbers for the specific expenditures. And I can go through this in more detail if you'd like, but I wanted to highlight at the beginning here on this budget summary page that we have adjusted some of these numbers on ridership and ticket revenue.